Hi, Rajan here at Epic Games. We recently made Epic Games Store achievements available to all games that publish on the Epic Games Store. After working with dozens of developers over the past few months during our early access phase, we are now very excited to bring this feature to everyone. Epic Games Store achievements build on the existing Epic Online Services achievements. So let's take a look at both, what the similarities and differences are, how they're set up, and what the developer and player experiences look like. The Epic ecosystem now offers two tiers of achievements, Epic Online Services achievements and Epic Game Store achievements. Epic Online Services are a set of free services that any developer can use to power their game with functionality such as multiplayer, voice, leaderboards, and of course achievements, regardless of where they publish their games. Epic Online Services achievements are meant as a functional layer for developers to define and integrate achievements into their game, without restrictions on how these achievements are unlocked, scored, or shown to players. In other words, you can integrate Epic Online Services achievements in your game, publish the game on any platform or storefront, and be in complete control of the player experience. The Epic Games Social Overlay does display Epic Online Services achievement unlocks and the full list of achievements when implemented in the game. Epic Games Store achievements build on Epic Online Services achievements and are, as the name implies, deeply connected to the Epic Games Store player experience. Adding Epic Games Store achievements only requires configuration in the developer portal to define XP for each achievement, so no additional code is required. Once Epic Games Store achievements are configured and published, players earn XP for each achievement unlocked, adding to their total XP. Epic Games Store achievements are tiered into bronze, silver, and gold, and an additional platinum tier is granted by earning 1,000 XP in a game. And because they build on Epic Online Services achievements, progress will carry over to the Epic Games Store achievements no matter on what platform that progress is made. To add Epic Online Services achievements to a game, developers use the SDK. Check out the links in the description for more information on that process. Setting up Epic Games Store achievements, however, only takes a few minutes in the developer portal, so let's take a look at that right now. Developers who have integrated Epic Online Services achievements will already have a list of achievements configured in the developer portal, as shown here. What's new is the Epic Games Store Achievements tab next to the Epic Online Services achievements. Clicking on this tab reveals the three steps necessary to set up our product for Epic Games Store achievements. 1. Have the organization owner accept a developer agreement. 2. Generate sandboxes and deployments. And 3. Select the primary deployment for each sandbox. Once the developer agreement is accepted, step 2 is to generate sandboxes and deployments. Epic Online Services user data is scoped to a specific deployment, so generating dev and stage sandboxes and deployments will give us 3 distinct environments to work in. I'll leave a link in the description to our documentation on sandboxes and deployments in case you're not familiar with these concepts. Once the sandboxes and deployments are generated, step 3 will become active. Here you will see the auto-generated deployment for dev and stage selected by default. It's likely that you won't have additional deployments created in the live sandbox, in which case the release deployment will be selected. Note that this primary deployment designation is used to define where Epic Games Store achievements are available and cannot be changed once submitted. Next, achievements will have to be created in the new dev deployment. They can be created from scratch or, like in our case, exported from our existing Epic Online Services achievements. We can export them by switching to the release deployment in the drop-down box and use step 1 of the bulk import-export functionality. Now we can select the dev deployment and open the bulk import export tool once again. We can now skip step 1 and download the Epic Games Store Achievements zip template in step 2 to see what changes need to be made to our exported data. After extracting the archive, we can open the Achievements Definition Template CSV file. Here we see that it has an additional User Epic Achievements XP column, which we'll have to add to our exported definitions. The localizations and stat CSV files can be used as is. Finally, we create a new zip archive with the modified files and go back to the bulk import export screen to upload it. When the page refreshes, the new achievements are shown in the dev deployment, and we validate that they're all correctly linked to Epic Game Store achievements. That's it. Now we can configure a build of our game to use the dev sandbox and deployment, and we can validate that achievements now show the Epic Game Store achievement unlock UI, and they grant XP. Now you know how to configure Epic Game Store achievements in the developer portal to add XP to your existing Epic Online Services achievements, and how Epic Online Services achievements enable any developer to implement achievements in their game, regardless of platform or storefront. I'm looking forward to unlocking Epic Game Store achievements in your game next and add to my total XP. Check out the links in the description for more information, and see you next time.